There are only 5 key pillars to elite productivity, but you'll never rise any higher than your weakest pillar, which means that you first need to become aware of those pillars, and then secondly, need to know how to improve them. And in this video, I'm going to share those 5 key pillars as well as some strategies to help you dial them in. That's what's coming up right now. Hi and welcome back to the Conscious Leaders TV. I'm Eric Matzner, I'm a leadership coach, and in this video we're going to talk about how to become a productivity master. And if you're excited about that, then smash that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. And now let's jump right in. And as I proposed in the intro of this video, there are only 5 key pillars to elite productivity, but we'll never rise any higher than our weakest pillar, which means we first need to become aware of them and then need to know the strategies to actually elevate those key pillars. So first, what are those 5 key pillars? The first one, you're never going to expect because nobody is talking about this. It is your identity. It is how you see yourself. Do you see yourself as someone who is productive, who is executing at a world-class level, who is like contributing at the highest levels? If you don't see yourself that way, no chance you're going to become a productivity master. So if you want to really be more productive, you first need to work on your self-image, how you see yourself. For a long time, I did see myself as someone who is procrastinating a lot, who isn't making progress, who isn't able to focus. And because I saw myself that way, that belief became a self-fulfilling prophecy. Because your beliefs are always, always a self-fulfilling prophecy. So first and foremost, we need to change how we see ourselves. And we don't have enough time to go really in depth on how to make that shift, but here's a broad overview. And if you want to go so much deeper, I highly recommend that you join my Productivity Accelerator Blueprint, in which I show you all the strategies to elevate all of those 5 pillars. But here's how you change your identity. You do something every single day that your future most productive, most focused, most crushing self would do every single day. Maybe you force yourself to be focused. Maybe you force yourself to make those sales calls. Maybe you force yourself to do the uncomfortable thing until it becomes your new normal, until it becomes your new standard. You need to change your identity first if you want to become more productive. Then secondly, and this is huge, this is so huge, mindset. Your mindset is so vitally important. There are many areas which play into this, but here are a few. Number one, do you feel like a psychological necessity, like a sense of, I need to make progress? I know a lot of YouTubers, for example, they're like, it takes them forever to do a video simply because they are allowed to take forever to make their videos. But if you feel like, yes, I need to make progress, yes, I need to get things done, yes, I need to crush it, and I need to crush it today, that's going to elevate your productivity so much. It's all a mindset part. You can cultivate that sense of necessity, but most people don't have it, and that's why they're not being productive. That second big aspect is your environment. Is it cluttered or is it simple? Is it like, do you feel like, are you crowding your brain? And are you stealing your focus by what is in your environment? I mean, that is so vitally important, and everybody can change something in their environment. It is so easy to do, but most people never do it, and they just overcrowd their brain. Then, like, another point is your focus. Are you focusing on many things? Are you focusing on things that do matter? And that brings us to pillar number 3. Your productivity will never be great. It will never be great if you don't have a great strategy. I mean, you can work all day long on things that don't move the needle forward, and you could call that being productive, but I just call it busy. It is just busy work that is not moving your dreams forward. So if you don't have a clear strategy on how to move your dreams forward, don't expect massive progress. And I know this sounds harsh, but I struggled with this in the past as well. But when you have a clear plan, when you have a clear schedule, when you have a clear strategy on what you need to do, and what you need to do until the end of the year, you're just being so much more productive. So have a clear strategy. And again, if you want to go so much deeper on a granular level, then join my Productivity Accelerator Blueprint. It will change your life forever. Then, big fourth key pillar is your energy. I mean, if you don't have energy, if you feel tired all the time, it's really hard to stay on top of your game. And simple things you can do, like sleep. I mean, how much sleep are you getting? Are you getting good quality sleep? Secondly, like, do you exercise? Thirdly, what do you eat? Do you hydrate enough? Fourthly, how do you deal with stress and overwhelm? Those simple things, if you can dial them in and you have more energy, you're just being so much more productive if you dial in those other pillars. And then the fifth key pillar is mastery. I mean, you could call yourself productive if you're doing the right things every single day. But if you're not progressing, if you're not getting better at what you do, if you're not becoming world class, well, you're not really productive because you're not really making progress. You're not really creating the results you want to have. So if you're not getting better at what you do, well, you're leaving yourself short. You're leaving your productivity short of what you could be. So mastery is vitally important. And there are three key areas. Number one, the standards you've set for yourself. Are you demanding excellence from yourself? Secondly, your skill development. Are you intentionally developing your skills which are necessary to really crush it in your career or your business? And then thirdly, and this is so immensely important, the depth in what you got, like go into your craft. Are you obsessed about your topic? Are you obsessed and have read every single book there is on what you're trying to master? Depth is so vitally important, and most people are just not going deep enough, and that's why they're not able to produce at the highest level. Those are the five key pillars to elite productivity. And again, if you want to go so much deeper, I highly recommend that you join my Productivity Accelerator Blueprint. But here in this video, I really want to wow you. I really want to give you excellent value. And that's why I'm deconstructing a few more practices that you can do right now to become more productive. So if you're excited about those seven key tips that I've got for you in store, then smash that like button so we trigger the YouTube algorithm. Subscribe right here, hit that notification bell. Now let's jump into those seven key points. The first one being, I want you, starting right now, starting today, I want you to start working in sprints. The largest study on productivity that has ever been done has shown that the most productive people work in sprints of 52 minutes. But most people, they work like a marathon. They work like 3, 4, 5, 6 hours in a row without any break for their mind and their body. And then they're like wondering, why am I so exhausted? Why do I feel so tired? Well, guess what? You didn't give yourself any breaks. So how could you expect to have intense levels of energy? So think about that. If we both were to run a marathon right now, it would take a lot of energy, even if we're trained. I mean, if you see people after they run a marathon, like they are exhausted. It takes them forever to recover because it is so much energy needed to actually complete a marathon. But think about it. If we were to run a sprint right now, we would give it all that we've got, knowing in 100 meters, I can recover. I can refuel. I could run a sprint like in 2 hours later. It would be possible. It is so much easier to refresh if you have a consistent break in your work. So every single hour, between 45 and 60 minutes, I recommend you get up, you bounce in place, you reactivate your body, you refresh your mind, you set an intention for how you want to show up, and then you get back to work. It's as simple as that. But I want you to start working in sprints. It will change your life. It will change how you feel each and every day. Then secondly, I want you to kill distractions, browse time, and FOMO. We are in that time of the year where like FOMO is everywhere and you need to be okay with missing out. You need to be okay with missing out on information that might serve you but isn't really relevant. That might be cutting down the news time. I mean, this is so vitally important. And also, like decluttering your inbox. Do simple things. If you remove them, you free up so much mental space which you can use to focus on something else. Make your life more simpler. Make it easier for yourself to actually focus on what matters most. And it includes like having a dedicated space to work where you're only working, where you're not doing anything else. That is so vitally important. Then tip number three, you want to have a strong, powerful morning routine because how you start your day determines how your day unfolds. And if you're not intentional about how you start your day, you're leaving your productivity up to reaction. Now think about it. If you start your day in the email, in your social media, in your messages, could you ever expect to be productive? You just don't know what you need to focus on. You haven't been intentional about it and you haven't primed yourself for success. So here's what I recommend doing as soon as you wake up. Number one, hydrate and get some light. Number two, exercise, get your body moving. Number three, reflect and like think about your goals and what you need to do through the day. And then fourthly, take some time to grow. It's that simple, but if you take an hour for yourself every single morning, you'll change your life. You'll change your life forever because you're so much more intentional about how you're showing up and you prime yourself for success throughout that day. Those with more intention will reach higher levels of productivity. Then point number four, and this is huge and I don't like it, you won't like it either, but it's so important. It is your schedule. You need to protect your schedule and use your schedule as a weapon. And like I like to be a creative person. Like I like to go with the flow. I don't really like scheduling, but I know it is critically important for me to stay on top of my A game and to know exactly what I need to get done. Because many people, they do have to-do lists. And they are clear on what they need to do and what they don't need to do. But if it's not in the schedule, you're just not progressing as fast as you could because you're leaving your progress up to randomness. Let me say this clear. If you're not scheduling your progress, you're leaving your progress up for randomness. And randomness will always land you in the land of mediocrity. So have a schedule. Schedule everything in, including your free time, including your workouts, including everything in your life, and you'll have so much more freedom in your life. That's so vitally important. Then point number five, and I know I'm going fast here. If you want to go so much deeper, I highly recommend again, and I know I'm pushing this hard, to join my Productivity Accelerator Blueprint. It is my best course that I've ever created and it will change your life. Then point number five, you need to 10x your energy. You need to really make it a quest to have intense levels of energy every single day. I mean, isn't it true that you deserve to feel great? That it is time that you master your sleep, that you master your nutrition, that you master your exercise, that you master your mental well-being? Is it time that you feel great every single day? Make that a quest in 2021. You will change your life, period. Period. Then point number six, I want you to measure your progress. Because if you're not measuring your progress and if you're not scheduling your progress, don't be surprised if you're not making any progress. So here's how I do it. Every single morning, I fill out the High Performance Planner by Brandon Burchard. And in the evening, this High Performance Planner asks me to review how productive I was. So I score myself on a scale of 1 to 5. How productive was I? How clear was I on the outcomes that matter? How much energy did I have? How much courage did I demonstrate and did I be my best self? Simple questions. But if you ask yourself every single day, how am I doing? Scale of 1 to 5. 1 being terrible. I mean, it was awful. I was a hot mess. Nothing worked. 5 being I was so productive. I was so focused. I was so clear on the outcomes that matter. If you simply scale yourself every single evening without judgment, you'll be able to increase your productivity so much because guess what? You now have awareness of what might be holding you back and what you do on your best days. Most people just have so much randomness in their daily lives, they don't even know what they do on their best days. They don't even know what they do on their worst days, so they keep showing up and reacting to everything else. And they're not as intentional about their days, about how they could craft their days so they continuously and like on end show up as their best self. This is such a simple habit, but if you got this in place, you'll elevate your productivity beyond belief. And then lastly, and this is so important and most people struggle with this, including myself, you need to ask for help. You need to ask for more help because if you're doing it all by yourself, you're leaving so much progress like on the table. So for example, here's a great example of someone who does it right. I've got 2 clients right now and they're starting a new business. And they know I don't have an idea of marketing. I mean, we're like they're musicians, so they have an intent, like they have great music, but they don't know how to do the marketing piece. So they hired me to do everything for them, which is a great move for them and a great move for me because it is a great practice of my skills and they are making progress so much faster simply because they get help from someone who's done it for a long time. That is so simple that most people are not willing to invest in their progress. And if you're not willing to invest in your progress in money terms, you're going to have to invest more time. And I'm learning this as well. I need to be better at this as well. But I simply want you to ask more for help. You deserve to have more support in your life. It could be emotional support, but also strategy. Also like the tactics on what you can do to move your career or your business forward. And if you like those points, then smash that like button so we trigger the YouTube algorithm. Subscribe right here, hit that notification bell, and then until the next time, make sure that you watch this video on how to achieve your 10-year plan in the next 6 months, and then live fully, live openly, and be the leader of your life.